This is Srinivas Lakhim. Today we are going to discuss ACL. ACL stands for Access Control List. Access Control List. What is Access Control List? Why do we use Access Control List? In last session, we seen CHMOD, right? What is the purpose of CHMOD? If you want to change file or directory permission, we use CHMOD. So by using CHMOD, we can change file permissions of owner or user. And group and others, right? By using CHMOD, we can change file or directory permissions for owner, group, others, right? But if you want to change specific group, if you want to change specific user, it is not possible by using CHMOD. By using CHMOD, we can change file permissions for group members, owner, others, but we cannot change file permissions on specific group, specific user. So to change specific user, we use what? Access control list. To set file or directory permissions. File or directory permissions to specific user. We use ACL. Access control list. To get ACL, we have two commands: getFSL, setFSL. To get permissions, we use getFSL. To set permissions, we use setFSL. To get file permissions, we use getFSL. To set file permissions, we use setFSL. Let's first see the difference of LS and getFSL so that we understand why we are using getFSL. Okay? Let's see practically. Okay, I am creating one file, cat hello. This is the file, and I am writing some content. This is used to test ACL, okay, control D, ls space hyphen l space hello. See, this is file and these are permissions for owner, these are permissions for group, these are permissions for others. If you use getFSL, see the difference. getFSL hollow. It's giving clear information, right? Who is the, what is file name? And who is the owner of this file? And who is the group of this file? What are owner or user permissions? What are group permissions? What are other users' permissions? But here, we cannot say, if you don't know, you cannot understand this one, right? And additionally, it gives some additional information, like if you give specific user, specific group permissions, then it lists that information here. You cannot find that information from ls command. Okay? Getfsl command gives additional information, additional file permission information. It gives clear understandable format. Okay? Next, setfsl. To set file permissions, to set permissions, setfsl, setfsl used to set file or directory permissions to a specific user or group. Okay, syntax for setfsl, setfsl and options, setfsl options, user colon, user or group colon, username or group name, username or group name colon, permissions space file or directory. So setfsl options, user or group colon, username or group name colon, permissions file or directory. Okay, see, in system we have multiple users. How do we find users information? Means there is a file called /etc/password file. In this password file we have a user called Srinivas. I want to set permissions to Srinivas user. Okay, see, so I am creating a file in opt directory. I am opening one more terminal. /etc/opt. I am changing user Srinivas. So here I am creating a file cat hollow, cat hollow, and content this is user to test ACL control D cat, sorry, getfsl file name is hollow. So for others we have a read permission. It means Srinivas user also has read permissions, right? So now as a root user or owner of this file, I am executing this file, hello. So I got content. This is normal user, right? I am executing hello file. I am able to execute this file. Now I am setting, I am removing read permissions for specific user. What is that user? Srinivas user. See, set fsel hyphen m username user colon Srinivas, user colon Srinivas, and I want to remove read permission. So how do we remove? Read hyphen, and what is file name? Hello. Export this one. Now get fsel file name is hello. See, file name is hello, owner is root, group is root, user for owner is read write permission, user Srinivas has read permission, and group has read permission, others has read permission. So as a normal user, cat hello, so we are able to read. Now I want to remove what? Read permission. So if you want to remove read permission, how do we remove? Hyphen. So for Srinivas user, I am not giving read permission, I am not giving write permission, I am not giving execute permission. Okay, let's execute here cat allow. Before that, let's see get fsel hello. See, Srinivas user doesn't have any permission. Let's execute this one hello. We got permission is denied. So Srinivas user unable to access file. So if you want to control specific user or specific group, we go for ACL. Okay, so if you want to give complete group or all users, we go for chmod. If you want to control specific group or specific user, we go for ACL. So to set permissions, we use setfsel. To get access list, we use getfsel. Okay, you got it right? Okay, thank you.